Hey everybody! Hello! It's Northern Lion. I'm Northern Lion. This is the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We're gonna play it maybe forever. Let's random. I really like the new random Iser. Instead of just picking one at random, it actually gives you a little bit of like the gambling serotonin release. There you go, know your limit, play within it. Alright, this is 8FYJ L6VS. Now to the top of my head, no kind of clever acronym is coming in there, so I can already tell that it's gonna be a great episode. Brains firing at all cylinders. Dude, does that have a hemi? Oh yes, it does, along with its cerebellum. Can you hear me yell? Okay, you don't need, you know, a streetcar named Marge references. And I know some people are gonna say it's not called a streetcar named Marge, it's called a streetcar named Desire. I'm specifically referencing the Simpsons episode called A Streetcar Named Marge. You know, you don't have to correct people at all times of your life. Are you one of those people that, you know, the teacher is writing up a lesson about quantum physics on the board and then they spell like variable with one too many L's or something like that, and you're like, oh, excuse me, teacher who has a PhD and went to fucking space, you spelled variable wrong, and then the teacher has to go, oh, thank you for pointing out my mistake, I really appreciate that, because they've got to seem gracious because they're the adult in the situation. That's okay. When in actuality, that teacher's like, man, that kid is a fucking asshole. Anyway, let's move on here. I'm Kane. Thank God we are not fighting Pin. Or sorry, thank God we are not fighting the Haunt. We are fighting Pin. Pin's a little bit more annoying than he used to be. But still, you know, very much an acceptable kind of fight for us. We got Mom's wig in our first room here. First item room, I should say, which is actually pretty solid for us. It's not the most amazing item in the game, but it's kind of like a passive Guppy's head. Or you might just describe it, I guess, as like a more kind of time-released version of the mulligan or something like that. Like, we'll basically create some spiders. We got meat as our upgrade from the boss, which is amazing, and we'll head down to the next floor. Basically, generate spiders at a regular basis. What I like about it is that it gives me the opportunity to kind of tailor my run in such a way that I can make this synergy worth... What the heck? It's been a while since I've... I don't know if I've actually seen in Rebirth the Eve's Birdfoot trinket effect. But anyway, what I'm trying to get at through a very roundabout fashion here is that we can sort of tailor our run to be a little bit more synergistic now if we want to. Like, for example, if we end up getting a decent amount of cash, maybe on a shop we can end up picking up a Hivemind or something like that. And Hivemind plus the Mom's Wig is going to be very nice for us. Makes our spiders much more effective, I think. It at least makes them larger, which makes them more interesting, I guess. You heard it here, size matters when it comes to spiders. Don't even tell me that size doesn't matter when it comes to spiders. If you saw like a 100-meter tall spider, would you be saying, oh, it's not poisonous. It's not poisonous. No. That thing will eat your brains after it starts rocking gold teeth and fangs, because that's what a mother farmer fonster do. Fonster? Monster. Coffee, still hasn't 100% made it up to the old cranial region, which means that if you just sit through me here for like the next 10 minutes and it gets there, things will start to become more coherent. This is anti-gravity tears. I know that we ruined our last run by taking Tiny Planet, and anti-gravity tears are another one of those items that people think is like Tiny Planet and can kind of ruin your run. I'll admit that last run was very funny because I like went off on that tangent and I was like, hey, you gotta learn to live a little bit, you know? Don't worry about it. If you end up taking damage, you end up taking damage, you know? Have some fun. Pick up shitty items once in a while. Take chances, get messy, make mistakes. And then I lost and I was like, oh shit, well I'm never taking Tiny Planet again. Unless like the run is already 100% sorted or something like that. But anyway, I'm making that same mistake again. I'm taking anti-grav tears because I want to be the guy who redeems these items. I want to be the guy who, you know, you end up saying, hey, maybe the items actually aren't that bad. So this is a bit of a weird one, isn't it? Because none of these items are truly fantastic. If I was doing like a run where I only cared about winning, I would probably take Gimpy and Ghost Baby and then 9 lives. We would have 1 HP, but we would have 3 items and 9 lives. But I think instead, why don't we try to start snagging some deals with the Angel? This is a pretty good opportunity to do it because we're not skipping out on any truly amazing items. And we need so many deal with the Angel items to actually complete our scrapbook, basically. We got a long way to go when it comes to that. Which is fine. I'm happy to do it, but yeah, in a different world, I might have tackled that room slightly differently, but I think this is the proper way, or a proper way to deal with it for now. Alrighty. Okay, and that is actually more than enough money to go to our shop, so I'm excited. Of course, we also want to donate. We also want to play the Three Skull Monty as much as we can if it shows up, and it seems like this is showing up like crazy now, but there's no way we can't take the blank card. I've seen so many cool synergies with the blank card. Things like, blank card plus Jera rune, which is abundance, I think, duplicates everything on the floor, or on the room. And then just duplicating all of the golden chests on the chest, like, 5 times, and then all of a sudden, you go from 4 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 32, 32 to 64. 64 freaking golden chests that are all guaranteed to pay out with items on the chest. That's silly. Anyway, I'm very happy to have the blank card. It's not like we have anything else taking up that inventory slot right now, so I'm feeling pretty okay about this. Ooh, I did not see this my first time through. And what's interesting is that I really should have, because that could have given me a spirit heart that would have given me access to... there's a few too many second secret room locations for me to love the idea of looking for one right now, but that would have given me maybe a spirit heart that would have given me much better chance of getting access to the devil room. So Curse of the Labyrinth, it's a lot less prevalent, at least it feels a lot less prevalent in Rebirth than it was in Vanilla, but it's still super annoying. Oh my god, we have blank card, credit card. So we can pretty much buy whatever we want from the shop for free now. Oh no, we can also use it on Deals with the Devil, which is a shame that we didn't get this earlier, because I would have loved to have taken some of those deals for free, but this all being said, still pretty sweet. I don't think we're going to get Deals with the Devil, but we can definitely use it to get free shop items. We'll see. There's our shop right there. And we found it so early, which is so good, because we can obviously get, more items the quicker we have it. So this is amazing. Just make sure not to use the card, and instead, you just use blank card whenever you want to buy something. This is not a shop. But there's a battery in there, which means... we probably want to open that. There's a battery in there, which means that we will... oh my god... I'm losing my train of thought because of this incredible luck that we're having here. There's a battery in there, which means that's like 2 free shop items guaranteed. I wonder if we can also... I'm trying to think of other opportunities we could have to use that. And I'm kind of struggling, admittedly. Please die more quickly. I don't like you right now. I don't really like you right now. I don't think I'm going to take damage, but I really don't want to ruin deal with the angel chances here. This is one of the synergies that I was most looking forward to seeing as soon as I realized that both blank card and credit card were a thing. So I'm excited to have them here. And it also means that, our money is basically free for just judgments and donations and gambling, which is great considering the number of times I'm going to need to gamble in order to unlock the remaining items in the game. I'm also digging this run from, like, anti-gravity tears. I'd played Waka Waka enough to have, like, a deep-seated resentment towards them. But at the same time, I think I've also played Waka Waka enough that I'm sort of used to them. And I have a little bit more acumen towards them than I used to, or with them than I used to. So now, I'm not good with anti-grav tears, but at least I know, how to somewhat effectively use them. Sometimes you just bait enemies into running into you, and sometimes you, you're gonna wanna set up like a Waka Waka chain like this, and then they'll just walk into it. By the way, Waka Waka chain was not accidentally a reference, or was not intentionally a reference to any particular hip-hop artist. It just happened to roll off the tongue that way. So I'm gonna use my key to go to the shop, rather than the item room. Yeah. Presumably, we could buy a key on the shop, even if I do have to pay for it because I'm buying other items. Who cares? Now, like, pretty much the ideal for us here would be a 2-item shop, 1-item maybe humbling bundle. I don't even care what the other item is. Unless it's shitty, I'll end up buying it for free, which is a really great price if you ask me. Okay, so we'll buy the map for free. Yeah. Actually, do we just get everything in the shop for free? I got a credit card confused with store credit. Oh yeah, this is excellent, okay. Do we know our pill? It's a range upgrade, and we might as well get the battery as well. Alright, that's pretty flippin' sweet. We also get Spider Butt. Now, Spider Butt doesn't generate any spiders, right? In contrast to its name. So it's actually completely worthless for us here. Oh, there's a second item room. I forgot we were on an XL floor. It's too bad there's not a second shop, but a second item room in and of itself. Still pretty useful if we can get another key. It's not like I wasted a key. I mean, I did waste a key, but you would have done the same thing. You would have gone to that item room. It was right there, and we had the key for it. Okay, so there's a potentially deal with the devil kind of wasted there. But I don't think it will be wasted. I think we'll still have a pretty good chance of getting Angel or Devil, as long as we don't take damage against the bosses, which is maybe a tall order. You know, this is an XL floor. Thank you for the other key. And Sacrificial Dagger, an absolutely acceptable item in my point of view. Weird run, but cool run so far. I'm into it. Bomb for a key is a pretty easy trade for us with our current kind of priorities here. I bet one of those is the secret room. We may never know which one, though, unfortunately. I could get that golden chest, but that really does not appeal to me. Yeah, I figured that would be able to do it. I think the thing with anti-grav tiers is just kind of having the tough act and tenacity to stay in there. And basically say, like, we're going to get a barrage up that is going to do damage to you whether you want it or not. Okay, Chubb. Chubb is like, if you have a decent speed, at least, and we do thanks to picking up the belt, unfortunately. You can set up kind of like an ideal sort of waka waka chain on him. And yeah, you don't even need to shoot at him for the most part, as long as you're just ensuring that he walks back and forth through these. Now, it might not be the most efficient way to actually get the fight done, but it's relatively safe. That's important. Chubb is going to be dead very soon here. And hopefully, maybe there's something like Squeezy, so we have an even lower chance of taking Red Heart damage against the boss. The next boss, I should say. Or just a Spirit Heart drop would do the trick as well. Ah, it's another speed upgrade. Not really what I was looking for, but thank you nonetheless. And it's Mega Maw. It'll be Energy Crystals. I know. The impression's losing its luster a little bit. But I've never seen an impression like this on Oith. Alright, I'm going to have to pause for a second. Because somebody had a message. Let's see what this says. Mathis Games. I assume no one here wants to play Dungeon Defenders 2 with me. Then Quill18 said, I liked the first one a lot. That is why, in case you're wondering why I get slowdown occasionally, it's riveting business-related messages like that. Now, if you just give this a second, it'll get normal again, yeah. I've also heard that it might have something to do with my drivers. Like, apparently on NVIDIA drivers, if you have an NVIDIA card, the game doesn't get as framey during weird other applications working. I did take damage. It's absolutely 100% my own fault here. I think I should have actually been a little bit more aggressive and tried to sneak in some more Sacrificial Dagger hits, because Sacrificial Dagger actually does block the fire. I mean, you have to be pretty smart about where you're putting it up here. Might still get a deal with the Angel. We didn't. We got a range and a speed upgrade. That is such a disappointing haul from a floor that could have been so much better. But hey, that's all right. We still we got the map for free. Nice. I don't really like the map so much anymore. People get on my ass. They say Northern Line, the map's not that bad. You just don't understand how to use it. I understand how to use it. I still think it's kind of bad. Sure, you can now divine. Oh fuck. You can now divine where your boss room is with a little bit of logic, but I don't think it's very good. Relative to other shop items, and especially relative to what the map was in vanilla. We could find ourselves losing on this run, and that scares the shit out of me, because this run is so cool right now. I really don't want to, you know, close my eyes. I also was thinking that maybe I don't want to fall asleep, because I might miss you, baby. And I don't want to miss a thing. Because even when I dream of you, the sweetest dreams just never do. Which is, I think, true, probably. Although I have had some pretty sweet dreams. Maybe that's the problem. Like, Steven Tyler, what kind of dreams have you been having? Because I've had dreams where I've been, like, in a, like, an intergalactic fucking war as a, like, Star Cruiser pilot. That dream is pretty sweet. Yeah, we'll take Pinky Eye instead. You know, Poison Tears. Relatively good item, or trinket, I should say. Assuming they actually work. I haven't seen any green tiers spawn, but I'm assuming that maybe they work nonetheless. Oh, there they are. Yeah, we had a couple. Really highlighting, unfortunately, how rare the green tier spawn is. It's like once every 8 or something like that. Not gonna win any offensive awards for that. Oh my god, my nose is so itchy. But I can't stop shooting! Alright, I don't like these guys, but I did manage to hurt one pretty badly. With a little bit of sacrificial dagger love to start this out with. Oh, come on. Gluttonies are so annoying. They're not really gluttonies, so I don't know what you would call these guys. Alright. So, the blood bank does interest me, I'll admit. It's more money that we could probably end up donating. We probably should spend a lot of time donating on this floor. Oh, there's a tinted rock in there. I very, very rarely see tinted rocks this late in the game. So to actually find one there feels pretty darn good. It also contained two spirit hearts, which is probably a little bit above your average market value for a tinted rock, which is something that feels kind of nice. We are coming up to the point where we're going to have to kind of put up or shut up on this run, though. Which is to say that we're going to need to basically pick up some damage or we're fucked. It's a very polite way of saying that. So I hate this room. Basically, I just anytime you have to fight these hearts or these masks. Because the hearts aren't so bad, it's the fact that the masks exist that causes the problems. Anytime you have to fight these guys, get ready to eat a little bit of shit. But we kind of managed to handle this fairly well. Only lost half a spirit heart in the process. We got Bob's Rotten Head, which is a bullshit item that sucks real bad. That's how I feel about that. Could be a secret room, though. Right? We found a secret room for free. That's not really worth an item room. Thank God there was another key in here. You know what? You're getting blown up, my friend. You almost messed with me there. Yeah, okay. We got an orbital out of that. This is still not worth the item room and now the key that we've paid for it, but it's at least a little bit more palatable. Just keep it moving a little bit here. Oh, okay, I walked into it, but I didn't get caught. That's the only thing that matters at that one. Because I do not want to have to do this room again, and we do have double the hermit card. Well, we might as well just use the hermit card. Right? But if we walk out, do we have to use a key to walk? You know what? Fuck it. You're really going to give me a greed fight. When the only thing that could save my run right now is good items in the shop, you're going to give me a greed fight. That is just petty, is what that is. But we got a Steam sale now. That should be great for me, considering it's not like every item that we were going to have was going to be free anyway. But I guess I shouldn't be... Oh, wow, that was some of the most impressive offensive pooing I think I've seen in... I've seen a dingle do, a little dingle do. Dingleberries, as people always want me to call them. I got the Waka Waka chain set up here. It's not really Waka Waka because we don't have magnetic tears, which is like a huge spot of good fortune for us because that item basically makes this terrible. So, I'm really, as much as I had talked about getting a deal with the angel, since we didn't get a deal with the angel on the last floor, we didn't get any kind of deal because we didn't earn one. Any tinted rocks here? I don't think so. Since we didn't get a deal with the angel on the last floor, I think there's still a chance we get a deal with the devil. And I would welcome it because we could take every item in the deal with the devil for free. Please die. Oh, thank God. Thanks to the credit card. And being able to get, like, maybe two or three free deal with the devil items would help out a great deal with the devil items. We got bloat. Bloat is, you know, oh, that's really dumb of me. I thought I could just walk up there and do some serious damage, but instead I ended up walking up there and taking some serious damage. Bloat's a pain in the ass, you know, this is not a well-kept secret. I really thought I could make it out there. A lot of people consider him one of the harder bosses in the game. Even though we've had, like, months or even years of practice against him in vanilla, I don't necessarily disagree. Dude is a real poop factory. Alright. Just don't... Oh, God. Don't get hit twice more. It's never good when that's your measure for success on a boss. Don't get hit twice more. But that's where we are. Oh, okay. Thank God. We lived. No special deal, and I've got to point out, okay? I think we're just gonna... We'll explore, and then we'll try to min-max this floor because it's fucked up. I do have to point out that, sure, maybe I haven't been playing fantastically, but at the same time, the only good boss item we've gotten five boss rooms deep is fucking meat. We got it from our first or second boss fight. It's a good item, don't get me wrong. I like meat a lot. Both in real life and in the context of this, you know, digital video game. That being said, we got meat and then two speed upgrades and two range upgrades. That is a terrible haul from your bosses here. Now, this doesn't necessarily excuse the fact that we're not playing so well. But it does put it into perspective a little bit. It's a lot easier to get credit for playing well when you have items that make that, you know, literally conceivable. Yeah, it was bad dodging on my part. Fuck this room, by the way. Like, fuck it to death forever. I think we had a spider come in there and help us out. Thank you. And half a red heart. Okay. Well, I think we check out our curse room because we kind of have to. And no spirit hearts, and then we got one spirit heart. You know what? I'm gonna actually check this one for a spirit heart as well. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go a little crazier than you would probably like right now. I'm gonna go that far down. Yeah, I really thought that maybe we had an okay chance to pick up. Well, that's a lot of money. Thought we had an okay chance to maybe pick up a blood bank or something as a result, or a blood bag, I should say. And we'll be heading down to the next floor. And I am not overly optimistic about our chances for success. I'm gonna look for a tinted rock here. Not that. I'm not overly optimistic about our chances for success, but we aren't sunk yet. It's just, you wanna try it? You wanna use our last bomb here to find a second secret room? Oh, okay. Feel a little bit better about that now. But the fact that we've had this cool synergy and have only really been able to use it to get a free map, that's like a 10-cent value. That is not what I was hoping to get out of the blank card. Blank card combined with credit card here. It seems like it should be such a cool synergy. In practice, not really helping us out that much at all. Did I really hit on that last barrage, maybe even the last two barrages, I hit zero of these the wall clingers. I am very displeased by this revelation. And should like it to be rectified in the future. Now we have no... Okay, this is good. At the very least, we should play our three skull Monty here. I don't know how many times you gotta play it to unlock counterfeit penny, but we should play. Oh my god, there isn't a three skull Monty! What is wrong with you? And two donations to our donation machine and it caps out. That's where we're at. Okay. Well, it's good to know, game. It's good to know you don't have my back at all. Now these guys do get hurt, I think, when they just walk into the bullets, so this is a pretty easy way to get that set up to take care of the Zambros here. Much appreciated. We'll go back for that. Obviously, we're gonna need some keys here if we're gonna make this floor work. It's still like, this is a winnable game, no question about it. But it's really gonna take this being a good floor. I also want to point out, while I'm being pissy here, that we haven't really had a good, a good assortment of item rooms either. We got Mom's Wig from our first item room. That's pretty okay. Please come over. Please come over. I hate this. I don't want to be trapped on this side with you guys, but I don't have the patience to you know, wait for you to just die. And then, you know, we got anti-gravity tears. And that's pretty much what's carrying us right now. And the meat item, of course, but this is a very, very unfortunate run right now. Now, part of it is me taking dumb damage against some bosses, not getting probably the deals that I could have gotten. But still, man, this is some rough RNG right now. But you know, we're down, but we're not out yet. I wonder if, like, this guy just didn't get hit by any of the bullets because the other guy was sucking them all up. Sucking on my bullets like you wanted me, calling me. Oh, anyway. Let's move on. These guys strike me as not so bad if we can just get in there with a little bit of, you know, sacrificial dagger plus waka waka action. I guess that's what anti-gravity tears are going to be to me for the rest of the game. Like, the rest of the game's lifespan. They will forever be waka waka tears. Oh, thank God for that key. So we probably should save a key to get to our shop. I was really hoping we'd get one there. I know what I just said, by the way, but I was like, you know, my patience does not know those bounds. So, unfortunately, we picked up Butterbean. Add that to the supply of Spider Butt and Bob's Rotten Head on the list of shitty items that we've gotten over the course of this run. Not only that, but we play in as Kane, who I'm not sure he's the worst character in Rebirth, but I do find myself a lot of times being like, why would you ever play as Kane now? Maybe that's just me. Maybe Kane's still beloved and I'm just missing out on it. I will say, the zombies are a lot easier to take out. Try to put like a wave of bullets here that it has to go through. Yeah, we can't get in there, but it's possible that our... Nope, I really doubt our secret room will be there. Alright, so we're really going to be hoping that we find a key or a hermit card. Either one would be acceptable at this point in time. Please return. Please return. Thank you. One key. That's all we need. And this will be the shop that has, like, fucking... I don't even know what we would want. Red candle or something. But we don't want red candle because we'd have to get rid of the blank card. And blank card plus credit card is the coolest shit of all time. This is a bit frustrating. You always want to see those, like, landmark Isaac runs, right? Where you're just, like, kicking the shit out of the game with this cool synergy that very few people have ever, thought of before. This could be a chance for us to actually make this work. I'm gonna look up here because our secret room is up, potentially up here, I should say. And it definitely was not below us because that room was pretty much inaccessible from, like, the other three sides. Two of spades. Yeah, we'll use... Oh, well, you blew yourself up, you idiot. Two of spades and the other one's credit card. The other one's store credit? I don't even know how that trinket works for us in conjunction with credit card. I think, to say the least, it's non-essential. So we'll just go down to our shop here. No three skull Monty and no ability to donate makes me a very sad individual here, by the way. So we can get the jar for free. Lovely. There's no point in that, basically. We might as well pick it up and then just put it back down. And we'll get a pill for free. The pill is... I'm not going to take it yet, just in case it's telepills. Get a range upgrade. Pick up blank card again, and then take the pill. Tears down! Alright! Okay, this is how it's gonna be, huh? And now watch, we'll get a deal with the devil, and I'll actually have to pay HP for it because I used my store credit buying these items that don't matter at all. Now, this is gonna be a bit of a tricky fight here. I don't think we're gonna be in a ton of danger, but oh, wow, I did not expect that enemy to spawn. We could take a decent amount of damage. Of course, I hope we don't. I really shouldn't stop using Sacrificial Dagger as brazenly offensively as that. Really, what I'm relying on here is our spiders. If we can get good spiders and, you know, have our spiders consistently do damage, that's great for us. Please. Oh my god. Okay, well, kiss goodbye our deal with the devil chance anyway. So I guess I'm not too salty about that anymore. If we were up against Red Mom, we'd be in an okay position, but because we're up against regular Mom, makes things a little bit more complicated. Dealing with too many enemies to really plan to use Sacrificial Dagger against the foot, because the foot drops so irregularly. I know it might seem like I'm complaining. I'm not actually. I kind of relish the opportunity to have a bit of a tricky run here, but we are running out of time for us to be able to salvage a win here. But at the very least, you know, beating Mom, I resorted to saying this a lot in vanilla. Beating Mom is an accomplishment. Not necessarily a great one when you start to get a lot of experience in the game, but it is, you've done something at the very least. You didn't just, like, capitulate super early. It's fair to say that I am incredibly disappointed with the way that our store credit, or credit card, blank card combination worked out. But, hey, maybe we end up getting, maybe we end up getting a Hierophant card or something like that. We haven't really seen many other tarot cards over the entire course of the rest of the game. Oh, yeah, thank you. Okay, we did get a deal with the angel this time. So we'll take our Polaroid, take our heart, and our deal with the angel is Sacred Heart. All is forgiven. Let's do this shit. Full HP, Sacred Heart. We finally got it. See, kids, that's what complaining will get you sometimes. Now, if there's only a way that we can ensure that we get deals with the devil from this point onwards. Now, our shots with anti-grav tiers will actually home in here, which I think is pretty sweet. Now, Sacred Heart is basically just a big damage upgrade with homing tiers. I don't know that this will actually give us enough to carry the game. Our shot speed is ridiculous, but I do think it's plausible, although, you know, we're going to be fighting some difficult enemies here. Not on this floor necessarily, but certainly on the floors that come after. This might be a bit of a weird situation now. We'd still prefer to have the credit card just in case we get a deal with the devil. It's a bit of a weird situation where Sacred Heart, despite being really really good, might not be enough by itself with the kind of run that we've been having here. Or it might be, and maybe I'm completely underestimating it, but we'll see. We'll have to basically cross that bridge when we come to it, as I so often say. That was really bad. What we should probably do, by the way, is take a look at our map and make sure we're actually traveling in the direction we would expect to find the boss in. That is damage I should not have taken. But we will get a little HP back here anyway. The boss could be over here. I don't think it's super likely, but it could happen. Now these guys, don't teleport. Thank you. As you did not teleport, my life should be easier. This is our boss fight. Okay, I'm very excited about this. All we need to do to give ourselves... Actually, it doesn't even matter if we take red heart damage. I think our deal with the angel chances are pretty much, like, the same, whether or not we take damage. Our deal with the devil chances, I don't even know at this point. I'm going to stop prognosticating as if I have any idea what's up with those. We're going to move onwards. We're going to be fighting Daddy Longlegs. Daddy Longlegs, not so bad. I would maybe prefer slightly faster shots right now to actually be able to consistently do damage, but... I was going to say, we can probably cheese it a little bit just by walking a little bit more slowly. That way, Daddy Longlegs will definitely fall where our bullets used to be. Oh, or maybe he'll fall right on top of my head because I didn't move nearly far enough. We're almost done, though. Yeah, well, that's a damage upgrade at least. We're certainly in a much better position. We didn't really get what I was looking for, but that's okay. Let's coffee up here. Even though we need keys for the chest, I'm going to check this out. I do not love this, but I'm going to do it anyway. Man, okay, disappointment. Still have one key. I would like to have more. Why is that disappointing? Because I thought we'd get enough keys out of it to make it worth our while, basically. Please, Sacred Heart, kill something. Spiders, you too. Our spiders are going to do more damage now. And I'm assuming that the boss room will not be here, but just because it's so close. But I thought it was a decent check anyway. Alright. I'm interested to know how this seed went if you played it a little differently. Like, how did this go if you got deals with the devil? It's a bit of a strange situation, but I almost feel like I would have been better off with deals with the devil even knowing that I got Sacred Heart. Or I was going to get Sacred Heart. But maybe I'm just being a big baby about it. I don't know. Ah, shit. How are we gonna get through this? Oh, here they come. There's more. There's more! Now we're done. Okay, that was actually fairly easy. Maybe a little bit overreacting. I think we should be able to beat Mom's Heart. The only question is how the hell we survive, like, longer than that. And I'm kind of at a loss, honestly. We can't even really give ourselves much more momentum by, like, running into the shots. Oh, well, that worked, though. We have to go to the big room either way. Try to get, like, a sweet-ass, like, Sacred Heart tier army here. Does take forever for them to fire. I think Sacred Heart is like a small tiers downgrade too, because the shots are larger and do more damage in home. You know, it's a fair trade to be sure, but I do think that we also had that tiers downgrade pill, but still. I think that's why we're taking a little longer than you might expect to generate these tiers. This is like my ideal room at this point. Enemies that are going to chase me and are relatively weak. There are some runs, like if you had Ipecac, this room would make you shit your pants. It's one of the genius things about Isaac is that, you know, different runs can be differentially powerful depending on where you're, or what items specifically are giving you your power, you know? Cool, this will at least allow us to have a period of Polaroid invincibility. I gotta say that for all the complaining I'm doing, and I shouldn't be complaining too much, because Sacred Heart, at the very least, worst case scenario on this run, we had a new item show up, and it's an item that I've been complaining about not getting for a long time. But, for all the complaining that I'm doing, the homing on Sacred Heart is so good. Like, it works a lot better than Spoonbender, I think. Maybe because the shot speed is so slow, it really actually has time to kind of reverse trajectory when necessary and then go back. So the real problem with this run in general right now, is that I'm only, maybe, the chest away from beating the game. You know, I'm only four items away from beating the game. The question is, can we even make it down to the chest? And I think the answer to that question, from my hunch right now, is probably no. Just checking for second secret rooms. Alright, fair enough. I think we beat Mom's Heart. Here's my prediction. And I'm not gonna, you know, try to work hard to make this dire prediction come true. I would much rather just succeed. But I do think that we may be dealing with a situation here where I maybe take a little bit of damage, two or three hits on Mom's Heart. This is the easy part, recall. And then probably just get whittled down on the cathedral, if I had to guess. But this could all change if we just get like an ideal... Oh my god, there's so much cat hair in this room right now. I gotta itch my nose so badly. If we just get an ideal tarot card. For example, if we are lucky enough to get a Hierophant card, that changes a lot. Especially if we can get like a Hierophant card plus Trickle Charge or something like that. Now, Sacrificial Dagger will block these shots. We got pretty lucky to not get hit there, I'll just tell you that right away. Thank God all the lumps are dead. Okay, here comes the Brimstone shots. Oh, I predicted the wrong way for those. Okay, she's dead. She's dead, I said. It's dead, please! Okay. I'm gonna take the half heart, even though it ruins a bit of permanent Polaroid invincibility, just in case we get a half heart on the next floor. If I were a boss, I would be probably straight down. Alright, ideal room. We need to stack up as many ideal rooms as we possibly can. There's our half heart. And again, like, this run could have gone differently if I'd taken a different spacebar item as well. Like, I really, really... I love blank card. And I would have loved for it to have worked out a little bit better for us. And I think it's maybe one of those... I wouldn't even describe blank card as, like, high risk, high reward. I shouldn't have taken damage there, by the way. I wouldn't even describe blank card as high risk, high reward. I think it's, like, high risk, a very small amount, or sorry, high reward, very small amount of risk, but, like, all of those chickens are coming home to roost right now. We've only had the Hermit card, credit card, which should be good for us, by the way, but we've only had Hermit card and credit card show up, and the Stars card, which is just a teleportation at this point. So, it's not like, it's really just a confluence of really unfortunate situations, I think. So we gotta beat Isaac without getting hit three times. That's not gonna be easy. We're lucky enough that even while dodging, we should be able to land almost all of our shots. Because the Sacred Heart homing tiers means that the momentum that gets stored in the shots is still probably gonna make them land. But as you can see, like, Sacred Heart alone is not gonna be carrying our run here. Maybe Sacred Heart is actually a little bit worse than it was in vanilla, I'm not sure. If we're gonna win this run, you know, there's not gonna be, you know, Tchaikovsky's 1812 Overture or anything like that happening here. This is gonna be a slow, drawn-out, methodical, like, meditative Isaac fight. This is gonna be, some people might even describe it as tedious. I would describe it as deliberate. We're gonna have to be, quite deliberate in our play here. Now, the real crapshoot is right now. We should be safe here. Okay. You should not stand where I was standing there. And we're safe here. We get a decent amount of time to do this. We should be safe here as well. Now, we have enough speed that if we're not safe in a corner... I don't know how to describe that, by the way. The feeling of knowing you're not safe in a corner. It just... it washes over you quickly. We're safe. Because it was in the corner that was above us. It's kind of where I'm coming from on that one. Oh, I did get hit there. That actually could end up being some very meaningful damage. Oh, we are safe. Okay. That could have been a little less touch and go. This is good. This is how you should be playing an Isaac fight. We're safe here as well. Ooh, I don't know if we were safe there, but we were literally safe because we didn't get hit, but I don't know if we should have been safe there. Oh, this is our problem. Thank you, Sacrificial Dagger, for helping me out in that brief period of Polaroid invincibility. Okay. With only two keys, we really need good stuff. Cricket's body is really good stuff. Wafer actually is amazing and allows us to take at least two hits before we die. Well, at least two hits now. Cricket's body, though, is going to be like a huge damage up for us. And a great synergy for Sacred Heart. So I'm just going to try to fire, like, pretty much only when we know it's relatively safe. Cricket's body gives you the splash damage, which is really, really good. Red hearts, please. Well, telepathy for dummies. That is bad, but possibly better than our credit card situation here, I guess. But our... oh, that's bad. Our shot's already home, though. Of course, none of these guys, by the way, would be gluttony, right? That would be far too easy. Okay. Well, we did get a key. Book of Sin. This could be very beneficial. Oh, it's a tarot card. The tarot card is Wheel of Fortune. So now we use blank card on Wheel of Fortune, and we play it. Don't get hit by that fucking fly. Okay, that's amazing. And we're just going to keep playing this, basically. Because we don't want to blow it up yet. Maybe we do want to blow it up. It became the Ankh. That's actually incredible for us. But blank card plus Wheel of Fortune. Sorry, blank card, not credit card. Wheel of Fortune. There we go. This is the combination that we want, because now every four rooms we get another item for free. And also we get a slot machine that we can gamble on for keys, which we need, obviously. And also, my brain is spinning because this is like a synergy I've never really seen before. But also, you know, the item itself. Items themselves. Now, of course, there is something to be said for the fact that we need to also just not take damage. That's a pretty big part of this whole plan. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. And we are fighting Super Greed in our shop. I so easily could have taken damage right there. But you're seeing the value of, like, Cricket's body right here. Cricket's body plus Sacred Heart is carrying us. I'll admit, straight up, we've been carried by the items we've gotten thus far on the chest. Were it not for these, we would have been screwed. That being said, all this being said, I think we kind of deserve to be carried right now. I think we've earned it to some extent. Now, we're still not doing as much damage as we've done on a lot of these runs, but it's going pretty well. Like 10 leapers leaping. I can't focus on what's happening. Make sure our Sacred Heart shots are actually getting in there. Most important thing is just that they land as consistently as possible against the gate. Stop summoning leapers. You're distracting, like, all of my tears here. There we go. You should be dead. No more keys yet, but another red heart. That's enormous. Cage is a fucking nightmare. One of the worst enemies, or this is one of the worst rooms that you could possibly be fighting on the chest. Almost no doubt about it. Okay, somehow we didn't take damage there. We're so close. I was gonna say, like, one of them has to be so close to dying, but we must have fucked it up somehow. I think we're gonna win here. I don't think it's gonna be an easy win, but I think it's gonna be a win. Theoretically. Trickle Charge probably beats Pinky Eye, because even if it lets us get one more item, that could be incredibly meaningful. Or one, not even one more item, but one more Wheel of Fortune. So we use blank card. We play the shit out of this. Don't explode until you pay out with, like, another key, as many red hearts as you possibly can, etc., etc. Holy crap, we're actually gonna get back to full health. And I'm gonna just keep paying out, man. Put it all on the floor. I will play this as long as is humanly necessary to guarantee myself the greatest chance of a win. We got a dollar. Well, that doesn't help us right now, but the full health does. Speed up. Relatively meaningless. Good. We should probably go to that big room to see if it has the boss in it, but I almost feel like I'd rather go to like four little rooms than one big room on the chest, because we could end up fighting all of the Horsemen of the Apocalypse on that. Oh my god, Sacrificial Dagger saved us so hard there. Dingles should be dead. Yeah. Key! Give me, okay, another red heart. Don't mind coming this way then. Give me a key, you goddamn asshole. Now, once we get into the actual boss fight against Blue Baby, no Wheel of Fortune card is gonna help us. So, oh goddamn, double adversary. So what I've learned against adversary, people telling me don't be an idiot against adversary anymore. What I've learned is that your best strategy is to just constantly stay moving. If you stop against the adversary, it makes it far too easy to hit you via that brimstone. So what you do is you keep moving, and then the brimstone comes out too slow to actually have a very good chance to hit you. Now, of course, we still do run the risk of getting hit if we cross into the brimstone charge while we're dodging backwards. But hey, this strategy appears to have worked out extremely well. Yeah, wow, that is just a really simple tip to make adversary much, much easier. All right, well, we come back here. And I really just want to gamble on this Wheel of Fortune, on the slot machine, I guess, until I get one key. If we get one key, I'll blow it up and feel pretty good about ourselves here. Tears Down Pill is probably something I'm going to choose to avoid, because it's awful. The Eternal Heart is relatively meaningless, but Fire Mind is amazing. Please don't explode. Yeah, we're just going to leave. This is fun. This is actually a really fun run now. By the way, don't expect Fire Mind. Don't expect our Eternal Heart to live. You should probably get ready to kiss it goodbye. But it's amazing how much we got carried on the chest. And you know what? I feel somewhat like blank card. Oh, this was actually the wrong way to go. But we got Fire Mind as a result. I feel like blank card vindicated itself. We bought it so early, and yet it didn't become useful until we picked up one of the more unsung tarot cards. And then, here we go. Blank card is actually ready to go again thanks to this battery charge. Although I kind of think we should just do one more room. And the reason for this is that we'll get a charge right now, after this room, I should say, thanks to Trickle Charge. And then we'll be able to pop the battery again, and maybe we can get, three more options here. Shouldn't have picked that up, maybe. Judas Tongue. Judas Tongue, not really worth anything for us. So, we come all the way back here. I apologize if this is a little laborious right now, but you understand what I'm up to. We can also get a trinket to help us out in the late game here. Isaac's Fork might not be it, but Curve Torn I think will be. Ringworm will not be. Our floor is going to be littered here, by the way, but the Spirit Hearts, if nothing else, I think... Oh, we got a key as well. Okay. Interesting. Cancer Trinket might be a little bit better than even Curved Horn here. So I'm going to get rid of Trickle Charge. What's this? World card. We'll pop it. We got Dad's Key. So we can fight Mega Satan. People are going to be mad if I don't. Maybe I should fight Mega Satan. What's the point in not fighting Mega Satan? First off, let's reroll everything on the ground. Two of Clubs, sure. Master of Unlocking. Another chest, which will become an item. Hourglass. We want blank card here. Yeah, you know what? Why not try to fight Mega Satan on this run? I think that could be kind of fun. So we're going to come back here and we're going to get two more items. So we'll use that, and then I'm just going to blow it up right away. For Scorpio, which is really good. You know what? I think I'm going to actually visit some more rooms and try to get more charges to get one more item. That might seem ridiculous, and it might even be ridiculous, but I actually feel like on this floor, we've gone from basically having no chance to pretty much being sorted. Maybe not against Mega Satan, admittedly, but We could beat Isaac on this run almost no problem. Blue Baby, I mean. Same difference. We could beat Blue Baby on this run almost no questions asked. So, I don't really relish the thought of fighting Blue Baby, because what's the point? You know, it's just to prove that we did it. I would rather fight Mega Satan and try to make, like, a mountain out of a molehill here, which normally means you're making a big deal out of nothing. But in this case, making a big deal out of nothing is actually kind of impressive, I think. Sack of Pennies is not that useful. Gotta be careful about these explosions. Those do still hurt me. We have the amount of good shit we picked up on this floor is actually staggering. I totally forgot that we have the wafer as well, so the wafer is one of the few ways in which you can augment the HP cap effectively. We basically have double the HP it looks like we have right now. What a cool run here. Started out maybe not being so good. Oh, we need to go to one more room to get our charge here. That's fine. Relatively not super difficult one. Shouldn't take very long for us to be able to kill one of these Mega Maws, and then just one more Mega Maw. Which makes our life pretty easy thanks to Poison Tears, Fire Mind, Cricket's Body, etc., etc. Alright, let's do this. I am ready. Wheel of Fortune, blow it up. Okay, Little Steven's fine, and then another Wheel of Fortune, and blow it up. Ah, Revenge Fly is actually pretty good. Let's take Dad's Key, and then we're gonna open this up. And I guess we're gonna use Hourglass. Lovely. Well, this is definitely... When I beat Isaac, this was not where I expected this run to end. Let's put it that way, but here we are. There we go, we'll slow him down a little bit. Now, we are doing a lot less damage than I've done on... Oh, that was real bad. A lot less damage than I've done on some other runs before in my life. That being said, it's a lot more damage than I expected we'd be able to output on this run. And believe it or not, Revenge Fly is so freaking good. I've seen this item talked up a little bit, but honestly, I think it's still kind of like one of those unsung items in Isaac. I think Revenge Fly is actually amazing. It's like a dead bird that actually has good AI and does pretty solid damage. You know, not my favorite item in the game by any stretch of the imagination, but decent nonetheless. Now, when this guy starts chasing us, he's totally boned. Because there's going to be all these fires here. And that's like the other benefit of Fire Mine. Is that, you know, these fires that kind of rage along here. That was really scary. They're going to make it very, very easy for us to do damage. Even when we're not firing, weirdly enough. They're still going to do like passive damage over time. So we're just going to kill Envy here, and then we're going to have, like, yeah, all the mini-bosses in a row are going to come fight us. That's bad damage, but honestly, I think we're actually putting out more damage than I gave myself credit for. I think we're maybe on pace to be able to do something very special here. And it is... Don't get me wrong. This is RNG. We got carried to an extraordinary degree. All of the items that we picked up... Well, actually, there were like 6 items that we didn't pick up because they weren't useful. But we picked up enough useful items to be very, very happy. We're almost done with this Mega Satan fight. How crazy is that shit? These angels are not actually that tanky when it comes to HP. They're a little bit unpredictable when it comes to their damage because the, you know, I don't know if there's a tell that shows when they're going to do like diagonal versus when they're not going to do, when they're going to do horizontal, I guess. But we're just at the head of Mega Satan now. And even when we're not aiming at him, our shots are going to do damage. Revenge Fly is kicking his ass. Where did your hand come from? You're not supposed to have a hand. Oh, right. Okay, I forgot about that attack. If we didn't have the wafer, we would be dead, by the way. But we have the wafer, so we're not dead. I think we just won. Orton, does he come back? He comes back for like a second here. Yeah, in like a new form, like a Smash TV type form here. Yeah, I don't love his rubber cement bullets here. These scare the shit out of me. But I think, honestly, we might owe our victory here to the wafer and Revenge Fly, as strange as that may sound. It's alright. You're doing well. You might have just won right there. I think you might have just won. There's your Kane Mega Satan kill. Well done. And did we get at least one new secret there? One new item, I should say? 311, we got two new items there. Alright, well, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed that crazy long run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.